All right, now to the Middle East, where Israel is on the verge of war with Lebanon. Hezbollah has bombarded Israel with more than 8,000 rockets since the October 7 attacks. It also killed 12 Israeli children. Israel finally hits back with the genius pager explosions and a series of strikes now. And yet the world is outraged that Israel would dare retaliate against Hezbollah. Well, I must have missed the anger against Hezbollah for the 8,000 rockets that it fired against Israeli citizens. They weren't at all targeted, those rocket attacks. They had the aim of killing innocent families. But when Israel dared to try eliminate the terror threat so families can move back home to northern Israel, well, the humanitarian groups are furious. Now, the pager and the walkie-talkie attacks, they were the most sophisticated and targeted attacks. Only the people holding the pagers were injured in the vast majority of cases. Only 4 civilians were killed. 4. And Israel was tracking each of the individuals holding the pagers, according to news reports. Now, the reaction from the humanitarian groups, well, it's so outrageous that it's almost hilarious to see supposed human rights groups become so deeply upset about terrorists being killed. Amnesty International sent out a media release today demanding an investigation into the pager and walkie-talkie attacks. They're calling them war crimes. Seriously, have a look. Amnesty said, and I quote, "The attacks were carried out indiscriminately and would be unlawful against international humanitarian law and should be investigated as war crimes." It's a joke, except it's not a joke. They're being serious. And the United Nations overnight also said this could be a war crime, killing terrorists. Have a look.
"Simultaneous targeting of thousands of individuals, whether civilians or members of armed groups, without knowledge as to who was in possession of the targeted devices, their location, and their surroundings at the time of the attack, violates international human rights law and, as applicable, international humanitarian law."
These organizations have truly lost all rationality and credibility when they oppose the killing of terrorists. And Penny Wong, meanwhile, sees this all as a reason to give millions of dollars more to the Hamas-controlled Gaza. She announced today a further $10 million for Gaza, taking the total taxpayer funds to more than $82 million since October 7, our hard-earned taxpayer money. And there's no accountability for our taxpayer funds. There's no legitimate agency on the ground ensuring that there's no misuse of the money. And UNRWA, as we know, has a long history of links to Hamas. There's little to show in Gaza for the billions of dollars in international aid over the years, apart from the world-class tunnel network, which currently holds 100 innocent hostages. The media reports are that Netanyahu overnight said he believes around half are still alive. Well, with all this aid flowing in from around the world, is it any wonder that the Hamas billionaires simply get richer and richer?